There she sat, at a round table in the corner of a busy cafe. Amelia sat with a stern look on her face, glancing down intensely. The cafe was a popular spot for all walks of life, planted on a corner of a busy intersection with a flower shop nearby. It had no shortage of foot traffic, with the decadent pastries sold just next door that added to the craze. Smells filled the streets. The workers continued to drill away at the concrete, adding to the decor of the town centre. Gardeners roamed with precision, tending to the care of the delicate, thirsty flowers. The flutter of butterflies, looking for their daily sip of nectar, and the bees buzzing in competition. If you looked close enough, you'd see that the cafe housed many and served as the hangout to many locals and tourists, including the cute couple meeting for the first time, the avid bookworm, the elderly couple enjoying their retirement hours, spending their pension seated with the sun rays bouncing off their backs, the nervous intern trying to make something of himself, the mums and bubs group sharing all about their daily challenges and successes with their bundles of joy cradled nearby, the local constable ready for a caffeine fix, the local guitarist strumming away, just trying to nab a coin or two, the group of schoolgirls gossiping, all adding to the hustle and bustle of the cafe with their snickering and giggling and bubblegum pops. Amelia, though, she had tired eyes. However, she still had a very caring disposition. Her shoulders ached and her feet were swollen, but she still always managed to share a smile. Amelia continued to glance back and forth between the clock on the wall and her mobile, as if the time between the two would vastly differ. She aimlessly swiped left and right and up and down and zoomed in and zoomed out on various pieces of text and visual escapades, immersed in her own world of liking and commenting and sharing and screenshotting. She just seemed a world away. Suddenly, she stood up as the clock ticked its last tock. The chair pushed out within seconds, creating a very unappealing screeching sound against the tiles, whose sound had catapulted right across the room. She reached into her pocket to find her scrunched apron and tied it neatly around her voluptuous waist. The little red bow perfectly tied and symmetrical from every angle. She glanced down, collected her phone, and placed it into the front pocket of her apron. She moved behind the wooden chair and tucked it in quietly, as to not disturb the cafe's positive aura again. Her break was over, and off she appeared behind the counter, hiding behind a smile were unfulfilled dreams.